of his prophet, Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to you, to the companions, said, ready Allahu anhu. May Allah be pleased with them. Greetings to each and every one of you. Again, assalamu alaikum. Shahadu an la ilaha illallah. Wahdahu. Openly bear with them that they're not worthy of worship except Allah. Wahdahu. He's alone in the room. He had no daughters, no sisters, no brothers, no sons. Contained perfect in what we would use as a jama'ah. The salat, when we do the salat, we will recite one third of the Quran, which is Surah Ikhlas. God is not born, neither does he give birth, he's eternal. Send his praises, highest praises possible for a human being to Allah. We bear witness to Muhammad Ibn Abdullah is the seal of Qatim Nabi. There will be no prophet coming after Muhammad. That God will continuously guide man until he wraps it up. Welcome. You know, our situation is not traditional, so it won't be a traditional khutbah, but I'm very well versed and their dad a khutbah. So nobody comes with any warning signs and tell me what he is. I have one boss on earth, the man Warsdeen Muhammad said. Thank you. A khutbah is based on the theme, which was gathered by a consensus, ijma'. Meaning it was a consensus of the learning that the theme will be understanding our human value to enhance productivity in society. I'm giving the subtitle because this DVD, inshallah, will go out to thousands, hundreds of thousands, and even millions. And the theme being the most competitive people on earth. I want to say to people who might be listening outside of this, this is not a put down to anybody. And I want you also to know as a people, this is not a put down to you when I start giving the medicine. I love you. I will die for you. But I will stand for you in Qiyam. And then in the Jum'ah, I ask the Mu'addat, the Qari, the father of the gold medal winner of the 400, listen, the 400 meter hurdle. I say, soon I will send you signs in the heavens. The Olympus is the heavens. Being the best people on. Some 1400 years ago, and the ones, the most worst condition ever experienced by people, a group of savages walking around naked at that place of worship. Gross ignorance. But really, to describe the situation, one would have to call them the darkest of the dark ages. Abject ignorance, misogyny. Chief Keith didn't have anything on them. Fetty Wap didn't have anything on these people because they were just like Fetty Wap, Chief Keith, Kendrick Lamar. They were great poets, but they were one of the most, they were the most unproductive people on the face of the planet Earth. They didn't just call our women by the names if I were in a male meeting that they call them, and we are going to have male meetings, to teach our men to be men and teach our women to be women. But they actually killed their to the rest of it. Eight essential things. And I want you also to register on your mind that this is the eighth year anniversary of the passing of our leader and the eighth year of our new leader, Imam Warad Imam. Allah sends a great sign. Eight factors stand out in the life of Muhammad. And you will also see that eight playing out throughout the theme. And that's a powerful sign for men who understand. I hate to tell you, dear people, this is not a book for spooks. This is not a book for the mystic. This is a book that came to thinkers and business people. And then those thinkers and business people spread it to the rest. The mountains, they were first offered the teaching. The government, they rejected it. All right. But yet, there were Christians in that era. They had that blood, they had that grip, they had that criminal, they had that shot callers. See, dear people, you need to understand religion, not in the sense you had in your Christian church. Because religion really means a real life. But this is called the deen of fitrah, based on nature. So really, this is not religion. Throw all your concepts, your Sunday school concepts away and understand. Scripture is telling us how to live today. God says of his book, that is the tabernacle, who that book to keep. Not a book for the crooks, not a book for the tricksters, not a book for the shot callers, not the book for the Machiavellians, not a book for the schemers. That it is a book who? The Mutafakim, one who God, who? God! I'm using common language. God, regard the family, and also regard the fire. They regard sin. God says again in his holy book, Ittu Allah wa Ittu Arham. Ittu Allah. Ittu Allah, Ittu Arham. Why would God say that in the same sentence? The reverence for him and the reverence for the womb or the place of birth. But in this environment, an altar whose mother had died, whose father had died, this is the pedagogy of the oppressor. Paul Ferrer, the great scholar, talks of. Pedagogy of the oppressor. I told one of my deeply learned African Americans. I said, when will we come up with our own pedagogy of the oppressor? I didn't really want to tell him. We got one. And I'm going to reflect from him to the best of my ability. That is, none other than Imam Warad Imam. But in this environment, continuing on, was an orphan. Mama, imagine it. Your mother died, your daddy died. And all you raised is as light as an altar. Put your mind there. Put it today. If you were there and didn't consider what we see on the streets of Chicago, and didn't consider that we without a mother or father, put yourself in this. However, this precious human being, educated to read and write in his tradition, and you fake checks, don't argue with me. Don't argue with me, I'm talking about facts. Now you're gonna argue with truth. This man was educated in the tradition of his people and could read and write. But he had no interest in scripture. Now a lot of my witnesses, what I've seen in scripture in that time, and even in this time, I wouldn't be what I'm either. So he had no attention. Meanwhile, they had monasteries. They they had churches and synagogues, but yet this man didn't steal. He didn't lie. He didn't cheat. He didn't even go with any woman that he wasn't married to. And he was so trustworthy that people left that life, knew that they could leave it at 63rd and Cottage Grove, knew that they could leave it with 125th and 8th Avenue. I'm pointing out some very dangerous places in these big cities.
That's right.
You left anything but a penny with it, you wouldn't find it. But this human being, without revelation, got the title El Amin, which was not a very common title in that time, because it's very few trustworthy people. So they need the language. Language is invented by circumstance. I'm going to move very slow with this material because I want you to get this. We're coming home. 2016, we're coming home. So wake up today. I've been accused rightly of being a resurrection teacher, as though that should put me in a bad category. If I were to dead people, what should I do but give resurrection teaching? Especially that the first day I ever heard El Islam, Imam Muhammad read not from the Bible, not from the lessons, not from the books of the shop callers. He said the dead must rise. The dead must rise. And I'm probably pre-Imam Muhammad. He wasn't reading for no lesson. No Bible. I just had to say this and register my soul. Speak from my soul, I'm reading. Speak from notes. Could y'all think that Imam Wahdi Muhammad II didn't know? He wasn't exposed to the Bible. He don't got your Sunday school mind. He wasn't exposed to Yaqub's history, which we got to deconstruct for you before we can teach you. Huh? He wasn't exposed to lieutenants and shot callers and captains and investigators. Daddy kept him completely away from that life. And now wake up, folks. God like Muhammad used to talk about hints, and I learned those hints. And then he came and said, the second Sunday. Son! Challenge. Now we're moving right along. This young man, this upright young man, was not only upright, there are a lot of upright people, they're like animals. It's like a sheep. The sheep is upright. That's why you have one of the four animals fit for sacrifice in Hajj, which I hope to go with our beloved leader from 2018. A sheep. They just go along, get along. They're good people, but they're sheep. But this young man was not only an upright man, he wasn't satisfied to just be upright. He worked in a group called the Hunafa. For what purpose? To improve his human nature without religion, without Judaic teaching, without Christian teaching. He wanted to improve himself. He was so impressed that a very rich woman asked to marry him. Picture that in Atlanta, in Atlanta, Georgia. Picture that in some of these cities we come from. Sister May had to get a police to evict you out of our house. But Muhammad was not that kind of person. Muhammad built her fortune, made her not just rich, fulfilling what God says. For what said it gets in land for Allah. And we found you in need, and what he do? Didn't give him his riches, he enriched him. And Muhammad built wealth. But he wasn't satisfied to be wealthy. He wasn't satisfied to be a human being that was working on his self-improvement. The Mason, the Mu'tah, the so-called Sufi group, that's all they do is work on that improvement. But Muhammad